What's the game?
I'm feeling a fortune.
Sally, it's the bottom of the ninth.
Coca-Cola bottlers across the country are offering millions of dollars in total prizes under any specially marked Coke or tab. Just peel, you'll find letters, instant cash, too. Spell out these words to win. Spell Coke and you get a chance to win $100,000. Look how close I am to spelling. Touchdown!
Peel a fortune.
Odds and prizes may vary. Check local stores for details.
Do something good for yourself. Wake up to a morning stretch.
Watch Morning Stretch with Joni Greggins weekday mornings at 6:30 here on Channel 5.
There's magic in the South Bay tonight. Story on night.
Good evening from Marine World, Africa, USA. I'm Richard Hart. These are obviously dolphins here. We're going to have a wonderful time both here and in other watery locations. We're going to be going down to Monterey to the beach home of Alan Funt to find out what the candid cameraman is up to these days. We'll be paying another visit to the healing waters of Soap Lake up in Washington State. Linda Harris is also in the water. She's swimming in the Bahamas. And we also have some ideas coming up from Susan Hemphill for gourmet cooks who don't want to spend a lot of money. That and much more on Evening Magazine right now. Let's say you were walking down the street one day and an elephant sat down on you. You'd be a little upset. But if you saw Alan Funt standing on the corner, you'd say to yourself, aha, I'm on candid camera. Everything's okay. That thing happens to Alan Funt all the time these days. He'll tell you himself.
The first form of candid anything was candid microphone, which is 1947. So it didn't go from radio to television. Columbia Pictures did 40 movie shorts, 10-minute shorts, which were called candid microphone and are still around somewhere.
I'm bigger than you.
No.
Oh, yes, I am.
Stand up.
Then in 1949, the first candid camera shows. And they went on, and it has been our history that every 7 years we get fired, canceled.
Alan Funt has delighted the country with his eavesdropping for 37 years. Candid Camera appears in 43 countries, and there are 4 books and 12 albums. So what is the face that launched 1,000 Bits doing today? Ranching. After a recent divorce, he moved to the California coast to raise quarter horses on a spectacular spread.
Are you here because you want anonymity?
Well, I didn't come looking for anonymity, but it suits my own style not to have to compete, not to live the Beverly Hills race.
So what are the problems of being Alan Funt?
1969, we're taking a crew from Newark to Miami. We're on an airplane, and in the middle of the flight, a guy shows up with a 10-inch butcher knife, and he has it in the hostess's neck, and he walks her all the way down the ship. And he gets in there in the cockpit with the captain, and there's this quiet announcement about, ladies and gentlemen, don't worry, this guy wants to go to Havana, I'll keep you informed. And I was, you know, everybody was frightened to death. And there's a lady sitting about as far away as your colleague up there, and she stands up and she says, Alan Funt, this is a candid camera game.
No.
And now the plane goes wild. Everybody's coming and saying, wow, put me on. How much do we get and all?
Oh, no.
And I'm dying. And this guy in there begins to hear all this noise, you know. So he tentatively opens the thing, and that whole plane load of people, they clap, hooray! And he jumps back in there. Well, I mean, that whole trip, even when the Cuban soldiers get on board, they gave him a big round of applause, you know. Nobody would believe it.
You would
wouldn't guess that this electronic philosopher is good with his hands. His sculpture graces the house on the outside and his woodwork on the inside. He's virtually rebuilding the kitchen.
When I work with wood or when I work with all of those other kind of plastic media, I get a sense of control and accomplishment, and it's easy to strive for perfection. In television, you have the limits of time and money and all the other practical considerations. But I love to work with my hands and with wood.
How did the motto for Candid Camera come about?
I think I mentioned to you that we were in grave danger of being a little rough on people. And so I determined, with the help of several other people on the staff, particularly a guy named Bob Banner, who was an associate producer at the time, that we had to create an image that would suggest that it's fun to be on the show. And we consciously set out to say, smile, you're on Candid Camera, to suggest that it's fun.
Now, many successful people today in the media once worked for Candid Camera, and there's some pretty successful people who didn't either.
There's a certain show, a talk show, that I'm never invited to partake in.
Late night, maybe?
It's a late night show, and he only lets me on if he's away on vacation. And that happened because we were looking for a host for Candid Camera about 20 years ago. And this young man had just done a quiz show and was looking for work. And I hated him. I really thought he was brash and very unreal. And that was Johnny Carson. And he's never forgiven me. Never forgiven.
But there was one comedian who's doing quite well in Florida.
Well, yeah. Now, Woody Allen was a very, very unknown stand-up comedian. And we gave him his first network exposure. I'll never forget the first thing he did. He improvises totally. We had a public stenographer come to an office for another stunt, and it didn't work. And he said, let me try something. And he dictated to this public stenographer a passionate love letter in business form. You know, A, B, C, and then he had to read it back. And he kept on saying, you're reading it so dull. Give it some expression. But he was simply wonderful.
Alan Funt helped launch the careers of Joan Rivers and Charles Grodin and others. But he's the first one to say that the most delightful people he ever worked with were the children.
So we should make a collection of money,
yeah,
and send it to President Ford.
That's what I'm doing. I'm sending $100 because I got $300 in my savings account.
You're sending $100 to President Ford?
I might.
You might. $100 out of your bank and send it to the president.
I might not.
Well, he may be as snug as an electronic bug in the rug here on the coast, but it's obvious that Alan Funt has not lost that glint in his eye. What we mean to say is, don't let this story lull you into a sense of security on your way to work tomorrow.
Don't forget, sometime, someplace, somewhere when you're least expected, someone may step up to you and say, smile, you're on Candid Camera.
Are you sure I'm not on Candid Camera? Alan Funt's got to be around here someplace. Okay, this is Margie the Elephant over here at Marine World Africa USA. We'll be in the kitchen with Susan Hemphill in just a moment, so don't go away.
Everyone's talking about money these days, so naturally a lot of people are talking about super checking over Great Western Savings because it's a little different. It works like your checking account, but it pays high interest, like a money market fund. Every dollar over $2,000 is swept into the Great Western investment plan automatically. So remember, super checking. It's a smart thing to do with your money.
Great Western Savings, a new brand of banking.
Smells good, huh? Mm. Come on, Sally. Money's tight, and you want Thomas's instead of bargain muffin.
Right, Dad. For us, there is no other English muffin.
Well, I wouldn't say.
Oh, Gramps. Nothing tastes like a Thomas's.
Ha!
You know you love those nooks and crannies.
Mm. Yeah.
So crisp and crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
And that original Thomas's taste. No other English muffin can copy it.
Like I said, For us, there is no other English money.
Right, Gramps.
The latest cancer findings are starting to affect our supermarkets. That story plus a lot of magic in the South Bay. Those stories and more on Nightcast at 11.
Coming up next, something for vagabonds and something for gourmets. Someone's in the kitchen with Dinah, and it's Susan Hemphill with some kitchen gadgets. But first, Linda Harris is adrift in the Bahamas.
Where can you find abundant sunshine, gorgeous beaches, and good food? Hello, I'm Linda Harris. One obvious answer to this question is in the Bahamas, but you know there certainly is more to these 700 Caribbean islands than just tourist attractions.
Of course, you will find all of the expected amusements. You'll also find some of the world's finest beaches and best boating. And championship golf courses. But you'll also find nature at its very best. And proud Bahamians ready to welcome you.
Come to the Bahamas and see our beautiful island. It's most fantastic.
One of the best views of the Bahamas you'll have is just as you arrive from your airplane window. Another nice way of seeing the area is to walk, and don't worry about getting lost. People will give you directions, and not only that, they may even escort you to your destination. But there's one way of seeing the area, especially Nassau, that you shouldn't overlook, and that's a catamaran trip.
In fact, a half-day catamaran trip in Nassau will cost about $10 a person. And just think of the memories you'll take home with you. Although there are a few sights to see as you circle Paradise Island, somehow that isn't quite the point of this trip. It's time for a little sun, for reading one more chapter, and for just being happy. On this trip, several people discovered they had all gone to the same Midwestern university, at different times, of course. Lunch isn't fancy, but it is filling and mostly liquid. And finished just as the cat reaches a mostly deserted island. Goodbye, winter. Hello, sun. Smile now. Back on board, just when you thought the sun had finished you off, the band comes back to life. And why not? Those of us who couldn't move much still could talk.
What do you like about traveling in the Bahamas?
The weather's been real good, but we like it because they speak English and they take American money.
Our energy level sinks as we get into port. Well, for most of us. But it's been one really fine day.
If you're wondering if the Bahamas are always sunny, the answer is much of the time. The temperature in the winter averages in the 70s and in the summer in the 80s. And the water temperature, 74 degrees all year round. Excellent for swimming. Setting up housekeeping, looking for a wedding present, can't find that unusual gourmet gadget? Hi, I'm Susan Hemphill here at Economy Restaurant Fixtures in San Francisco. Although most items are stocked for commercial restaurant use, there are some simmering steals for the household. I like this place because they love to deal. Whatever the price tag says is not what you pay. Automatically deduct 20%. And if they're in a generous mood or you're buying in quantity, the price may be shredded and chopped again. I think the best deals are on their sturdy commercial chinaware. Very hard to break. Now, there is a slight decorative flaw in each item. In perfect condition, they'd sell for about $69 a dozen. Knocking off $49, these run about $20 a dozen. Two dozen herringbone towels, regularly about $15, sell here for $7.50. A delight for the culinary artist. They carry all sorts of cookware, from wire whisks and pots and pans to vegetable juicers and commercial quality stoves. Beware, not everything in this store is a bargain. The standard 20% is not a large markdown, so make sure you know the regular retail price of the item you want to buy. And don't expect a lot of sales help. They'll probably help the restaurant owner first. There are no cash refunds, and returns must be made within 3 days. They do accept Visa and MasterCard. Economy Restaurant Fixtures is on 952 Mission Street in San Francisco. Robin Sales, a few doors down, also sells restaurant supplies at good prices. So if you're gonna whip up a confection, why not find a sweeter deal?
improvement to famous Glidden Spread House Paint, but it's not on the label because the improvement's in the price. Now Spread House Paint is on sale for only $11.99 a gallon. And the same great improvement applies to Glidden Spread Oil Stain. It's on sale for just $10.99 a gallon. But you better hurry. Glidden Spread Oil Stain and Spread House Paint will always be great, but the prices may never be better.
Glidden, when you make a very good paint, it shows.
Pick yourself some savings at Alpha Beta's summer fruit sale.
The savings don't stop.
Just when summer fruit's at its sweetest, Alpha Beta's selling the tastiest peaches and the juiciest nectarines at our cost. So any way you enjoy serving these delicious fruits, you'll enjoy the savings too. With peaches and nectarines at the peak of their flavor and Alpha Beta's price down to our cost, it's a peach of a sale.
At Alpha Beta, the savings don't stop.
Tell a friend.
Let's go, John.
Once around now. Nice and easy, okay?
Sure, John.
Hey, not so fast.
Right off the floor, the Toyota Celica Super. 4.8-liter engine, wind cam,
hey,
independent suspension, front rear.
Solid
rapid wheel steering and 10-inch disc brakes.
Toyota, number one selling import in Northern California. Great being with a number one team.
One more lap, Coach?
To most women, Gloria Steinem is the epitome of the women's movement. On our next People Are Talking, she'll join us and reveal where she thinks the women's movement is headed now that the ratification of the ERA is almost certain to fail.
Join Ann and Ross for People Are Talking tomorrow morning at 10 on Channel 5.
Playing around in the water is great fun for animals and humans, and you can't deny that it's therapeutic. I mean, swimming is great for muscle tone and cardiovascular conditioning. But psoriasis and arthritis cures? We ran a story about 3 months ago about a lake in Washington called Soap Lake, and there are some amazing claims for the waters there. So we sent Evening's Elaine Busby back there to actually talk to some of the people who are taking the cure.
This may look like mud madness, but believe it or not, there is a method to all of this. The creamy black mud and rich mineral water of Soap Lake, Washington, contain healing properties which have changed the lives of thousands who have come here for a cure. But to go back in time for a moment, this is where the Soap Lake story begins, over 30 million years ago. During this glacial period, Soap Lake was a huge waterfall. Its waters receded to what is considered a geological wonder, dry falls. What was left behind was a series of mineral-rich lakes, Soap Lake being the richest of them all. In fact, there is only one other place in the world that can match the healing powers of Soap Lake. That is the famous Baden-Baden Health Spa in Germany. The person who probably knows the most about Soap Lake is Roxy Thorson, Queen of the Salt Mines. She is nearly a century old, and she has been harvesting Soap Lake salts and selling them for over 60 years.
It heals any kind of skin trouble, eczema especially. Absolutely good for psoriasis. I've had people stay here and was covered with psoriasis. I don't hardly have stood it. And in 1 month, they'd be well.
People who come to Soap Lake usually end up taking some of the lake home with them in the form of salts, ointment, and shampoo. Roxy's method of extracting salts is simply evaporation, boiling, grinding, and packaging, and there is definitely no hard sell here.
Nope, never did spend a cent on advertising.
Yet Roxy has sold her salts all over the world. She has received hundreds of letters touting the glories of Soap Lake salts. As far as the medical profession, Roxy believes they view this with more than a grain of salt.
I tell you, doctors make fun of Soap Lake salt.
Much of the medical profession feels that the minerals in the lake and the water are comparable to Epsom salts, but I find they've been much more beneficial than that.
Dr. Wayne Piper is one doctor who doesn't make fun of Soap Lake. However, he is cautious not to label it a cure-all.
Well, it seems to really help quite a few of the psoriasis-type patients and then other chronic eczematoid or type of dermatitises and long-standing dermatitises. but it doesn't help every patient, and it's difficult to predict exactly which patient's going to benefit and which one isn't going to benefit. It really has helped patients with rheumatoid arthritis, and I've seen it really help many, many patients with osteoarthritis. And again, it's because of its tremendous buoyancy, which helps the patient to move its extremity up and down.
My wife has brought up with arthritis and you name it in the joints, you know. And she used to take cortisone shots in San Diego. And my son is up there, and we decided to move up here because we found about the water. And since she's been up here and it is water, and we even have it pumped into our summer home, in the last 3 years she hasn't even been bothered.
Well, I've got arthritis in my knees. And then this shoulder has got a little pain in it, too, at times. And so I thought I'd just put it on there and see if it would help it.
You may recognize this woman as a longtime family friend. She's Norma Zimmer, better known as the Champagne Lady on the Lawrence Welk Show.
We just love it because our son had psoriasis on his legs, and he came and spent an entire year here at Soap Lake, and he hasn't suffered from psoriasis since.
Not at all.
And we had a young man working for us, a Roy Holt, who had been in the service and was in the jungles, and he got jungle rot on his feet. He went to specialist after specialist, and they said they couldn't do anything about it. He spent 2 weeks at Easter time here about 6 years ago, waded in the lake several times a day, and he has never had that jungle rot come again.
Of all the stories Soap Lake has to tell, this is perhaps the most amazing.
His legs were completely black from the knees down. They were just black as your slacks are. And there were open ulcers, quite a few open ulcers, all the way down his legs.
Mary Beth Smith is describing a very rare illness her husband contracted called Berger's disease. The disease is characterized by little or no circulation in the limbs. The prognosis was very bleak.
The doctors had told him one leg had to come off right then, and they wouldn't give him more than 6 months till he would lose the other leg.
A friend told Mary Beth and her husband about Soap Lake and advised them to move there for treatment. Though skeptical, their choice was clear.
Yes, you're always a little skeptical, but you're willing to give anything a try. When you sounds like you're going to lose both your legs, you'll try anything.
After months of a strict regime of drinking the water, soaking in it, and using the mud, his disease went into remission. It wasn't until years later that he died, but with a lot more than doctors said he would ever have.
It was 20 years later before he died, but he still had both legs when he died.
I always figured the man upstairs guided me here, and in fact, I know it.
Ted Feldman has had Berger's disease since 1940. He, too, faced amputation of his legs until a friend told him about Soap Lake.
And we all went down here, and I was ashamed to take my socks off, see, because I had such a awful sore. And I figured they'd run me out off the beach, and they see me get out there in that water. And Hart says, no, he says, about half of them are here to get rid of something.
Ted didn't get rid of his disease, but he did get rid of his pain and the prospect of losing his legs. And no one believes more in this lake than he does.
I am convinced that if it wasn't for this lake, I wouldn't have these legs. I know I wouldn't have. And every year that healing water stays there, I thank my God it's there, because we who are afflicted love it and need it. And I hope nothing ever happens to it.
Unbelievable. That was pretty close to 18 feet, and unbelievable is the word. That was a pilot whale here at Marine World Africa USA. Unbelievable is the way to describe that story you just saw, too. Frankly, we haven't seen any evidence that any waters anywhere can heal anything. So if you go there for psoriasis and arthritis, you are taking a chance. Frankly, my opinion is if you believe that, you'll believe that the garage will be finished someday at San Francisco Airport. Okay, we're going to take a short break here. In just a minute, we'll show you another Evening Magazine finalist in the co-host contest.
Spend time in the hospital and you'll spend $460 a day. And more.
X-ray reports.
Even Medicare doesn't cover everything.
Scans.
This year, one out of every seven Americans will wind up in the hospital.
Well, it definitely looks like surgery.
So maybe you'll have to spend the time.
Don't worry.
will have you out of here in no time at all. But you don't have to spend the money. Not if you call Blue Cross now, just in case.
KitchenAid believes in the quality of this KD20 dishwasher so much they're making you this offer. If you can find another dishwasher with all the features found in KitchenAid, they'll buy it for you. If you find any other dishwasher with a high-pressure multi-level wash system, durable porcelain and steel construction, and all these other quality features, KitchenAid will buy it for you. So look for this checklist at your appliance dealer and compare.
People used to tell me that I wouldn't be sleek or slinky if I drank milk. But I drink milk because I love it. I love the way it tastes when it's served ice cold. It's so light and refreshing. And I especially like that satisfied feeling you get when you finish a glass of milk. And besides, what's the sleekest, slinkiest creature of all? And how do they feel about milk? I'm drinking milk for good.
Tonight on Eyewitness News Nightcast at 11, the story of the nightmare on an Amtrak train. Reporter David Jackson at the scene of that tragedy reports on why investigators think it may have been started by an arsonist. And he talks with survivors who say the deaths may have been prevented. Surprise news tonight about another company that might try to buy the Oakland Raiders. And those controversial crime fighters, the Guardian Angels, are hitting the streets in another major Bay Area city tonight. They'll show you how they plan to make that city safer tonight on Nightcast at 11.
All right, we've already shown you two of our Evening Magazine co-host for a day contest semifinalists. Coming up now, contestant number three. Watch carefully. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Evening Magazine.
I'm Kat Taylor, and this is Richard Hart. Hi, Richard.
You bet. Hi, Kat. You're a happy little co-host, aren't you, Kat?
Yes, I am.
Who's our first story tonight?
Arnold, walking side of beef, Schwarzenegger.
Oh, that's right. Nerves of steel and head of concrete.
If my lips were long, I could kiss you from here. Arnold! Oh.
Well, kiss me. Coming up in our second story tonight, after Arnold Schwarzenegger, there's a woman who does excite people with romance novels. She writes all of these sexy things while she's cooking and doing the laundry, because she's an ordinary housewife.
Are you a romantic?
Actually, I'm an eclectic.
Busting you.
No. Actually, I'm a Scorpio.
Mm-hmm.
I want to get out of here. No. Well, what do you think? You've already seen three semifinalists so far, and you'll see a couple more at the ends of the shows tomorrow and the day after. After you've seen all five, next week we'll give you a phone number where you can vote. Next Wednesday, everyone will telephone in a vote for his or her favorite, and the winner gets to co-host the show while Jan Yanahiro is away. Don't forget to watch carefully the next couple of days, too. Watch carefully tomorrow on Evening Magazine, because we've got the best shot in the Bay Area for you. This man is an expert with a shotgun, and the things he can do, including trick shooting, will amaze you. We'll also go and attend an amazing reunion between two sisters who haven't seen each other for 30 years. Rich, full, long hair is a possibility for everyone. Joni Greggins will show us how, and Don Blue has an instant fun weekend for us. From Marine World, Africa, USA, giddy up. I mean, for Jan and me, good night, everybody.
Presenting Ronald McDonald in Where's Ronald?
Hi, kids! Where? Over there?
No!
Under here?
No!
Up there?
No!
Then I must be right here at McDonald's!
Yeah!
Come see the Ronald McDonald Show at McDonald's, 1:30 p.m. Saturday, June 26, 1691 Monument Boulevard at Virginia in Concord, and join the fun.
Introducing the unexpected granola bar.
This is a granola bar?
New chewy granola bars.
Unexpected.
From Quaker.
It isn't hard and crumbly.
Unexpectedly moist. Unexpectedly moist and chewy.
Mine is chocolate chip.
Deliciously new chewy granola bars from Quaker. If you've never been excited about a granola bar before, you haven't tried the unexpected granola bar.
Unexpected.
New Quaker chewy granola bars.
Are you sure this is a granola bar?